गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, इन टुडे वी स्टार्ट द न्यू चैप्टर विच चैप्टर नंबर 8 इज द योर क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. ओके, इन द प्रीवियस चैप्टर वी हैव स्टडीज मेनी प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ ट्राइंगल लाइंस एंड एंगल्स. ओके, लाइक ट्रांसवर्सल वर्टिकली अपोजिट एंगल्स, अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल, कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग एंगल्स, ट्रांसवर्सल and internal bisector of angle, triangle, angle some property of the triangle, and some exterior angle property, interior angle property, angle bisectors of a triangle, so etc. Now, in this chapter, we study about quadrilaterals, okay? And what is quadrilateral? A line segment bounded by a bounded region, a region bounded by four line segments. The simple definition of quadrilateral is a region bounded by four line segments. Four line segments is called quadrilateral. Okay, a plane region bounded by a plane figure bounded by four line segments is called quadrilateral. Okay, the word quad means four. The quadrilateral made for two words, quad plus lateral, they form quadrilateral. Okay, the word quad means four and the word lateral means sides. So we can say that a plane figure bounded by four line segment. A plane figure bounded by four line segments is called quadrilateral because of the quadrilateral made for two words, quad plus lateral. Quad means four, lateral means sides. So a plane figure bounded by four line segments is called quadrilateral. Okay, so thus we can say that the figure of quadrilateral, any quadrilateral is, let's see the figure here, ABCD is called the quadrilateral. Okay, here four line segments are AB, BC, CD and DA. These are the four line segments and the points A, B, C, D are called its vertexes. Here the point A, B, C and D are called its vertices. Vertices of quadrilateral. Okay. And the four line segments A, B, B, C, C, D and DA are called its four sides. These are the four sides of the quadrilateral. Okay, and the four angles, that is angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D, are called the angles of quadrilaterals. Okay, and one important thing is that here the line segment AC and BD, the line segments AC and BD which joins the opposite vertices are called diagonals of quadrilateral. Okay, so the line segment AC and BD are called diagonals of क्वाड्रिलेटरल ए बी सी डी. ओके, हेयर ए सी एंड बी डी आर कॉल्ड द डायगोनल्स ऑफ क्वाड्रिलेटरल्स. सो इन दिस वे वी कैन से दैट अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल हैज फोर साइड्स, फोर वर्टिसेस एंड फोर एंगल्स एंड टू डायगोनल्स एंड टू डायगोनल्स. ओके, नाउ ऑल्सो वी हैव द फॉलोइंग डिफिनेशंस रिलेटेड टू क्वाड्रिलेटरल. ओके, नाउ वी डिस्कस अबाउट consecutive, consecutive or adjacent sides. Adjacent sides. Okay. Consecutive or adjacent sides. Okay. Let's take two sides of any quadrilateral are consecutive or adjacent side if they have the common points. They have the common points. So we in the given figure, the side ABBC, the pair of sides ABBC which have the common point or vertex, so they are called adjacent sides. Similarly, the side BC and CD. Similarly, the side BC and CD is also the adjacent side because of these are the common vertex O. Okay, similarly side CD and DA. CD and DA also known as the adjacent sides. Now finally DA and AB. DA and AB are also the pair of adjacent side because they have the common vertex or common point A. So in this way, in any quadrilateral there are four pairs of adjacent sides. Four pairs of adjacent sides. Okay, so in any quadrilateral there are four pairs of adjacent sides. Okay, two sides are said to be adjacent if they have the common vertex or common point. Now we discuss about opposite sides. It is also very easy. Two sides of a quadrilateral are opposite sides if they have no common end point, that is no common vertex. So in this way we find that we have AB and CD are the pairs of opposite sides and AD and BC are two pairs of opposite sides. So in any quadrilateral, two pairs of opposite sides are ABCD and ADBC. Okay, AD and BC, these are the pairs of opposite sides. Okay, they have the no common vertex or point. Now same as on the basis of consecutive adjacent sides there are consecutive angles, and on the basis of opposite sides there are opposite angles. Okay, so same as the consecutive angles of the quadrilateral are two angles which included a side in their intersection. In other words, two angles are consecutive if they have the common arm. So here एंगल ए एंड बी हैव द कॉमन आर्म, सिमिलरली एंगल बी एंड एंगल सी आर द कॉमन आर्म्स, सी एंड डी, डी एंड ए एंड ए एंड बी. इन दिस वे देर आर फोर पेयर्स ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स एंड अपोजिट एंगल्स. टू एंगल्स ऑफ अ क्वाड्रिलेटरल आर सेड टू बी अपोजिट एंगल इफ दे डू नॉट हैव कॉमन आर्म, दैट इज एंगल ए एंड एंगल सी आर अपोजिट एंगल अपोजिट एंगल एंड सेम एज एंगल बी एंड एंगल डी आर अपोजिट एंगल. सो देर आर टू पेयर ऑफ अपोजिट एंगल्स एंड फोर पेयर ऑफ एडजेसेंट एंगल्स ऑफ एनी क्वाड्रिलेटरल. नाउ वी हैव टू डू सम थ्योरम बेस्ड ऑन क्वाड्रिलेटरल एंड वी सॉल्व सम क्वेश्चंस बेस्ड ऑन देम. ओके, लेट्स सी अ थ्योरम, टेक अ थ्योरम. The sum of four angles of a quadrilateral lateral is 360 degree. Okay, the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degree. This is your theorem. The sum of four angles of a quadrilateral is 360. Now we prove it. Let's see. First of all, you write the given. First of all, we draw a quadrilateral. A, B, C, D. Given a quadrilateral A, B, C, D. Okay. And next point to prove. We have to prove that the sum of all angles of this quadrilateral, that is angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, is 360. Okay, now we have to show that angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is 360. Now we have to do some construction. We have to do some construction. We join, very easy construction, we join simply AC. Okay. And take that is angle 1, that is angle 2. Okay. That is angle 3, that is angle 4. This is angle 5, this is angle 6. Okay. Construction, simply we join AC. Okay, now we prove it. Now your next heading is proof. Okay, now first of all, in triangle ABC we use the angle sum property of the triangle. In triangle ABC, that is angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 is equal to 180, na? Okay. Now, in triangle ABC, we use the angle sum property of the triangle. We use the angle sum property of the triangle. In triangle ABC, we get angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 is equal to 180 degree. Take equation number 1. Similarly, Similarly,
we use the angle sum property in triangle ACD as angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5 is also equal to 180. Okay, similarly, we use the angle sum property in triangle ACD.
Similarly, in triangle ACD, we use the angle sum property of the triangle. We get what? Angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degrees. Take equation number 2. Now we formed two equation, 1 and 2. Now adding these equation, okay, now we add equation 1 and 2. We add equation 1 and 2, we get left and right add. Now we get angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 plus 180. Now here we take angle 1 and angle 2 together, angle 1 plus angle 2 plus, and we take angle 3 and angle 4 together, angle 3 plus angle 4, okay, plus angle 5 plus angle 6 right here is equal to 180 plus 180. 180 and 180, that is 360. Okay, now from figure let's see, angle 1 plus angle 2, that is angle A. We write angle 1 plus angle 2 that as angle A, plus same as angle 3 plus angle 4 we write angle C. Okay, so here we write angle 3 plus angle 4 as angle C, plus angle 5 right as angle D, and angle 6 right as angle D. Okay, so here angle 5 as angle D and angle 6 as angle B is equal to 360. So in this way we have angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360. Is equal to 360. Proof. Okay. In this way, we proved this result. This is very important results, and so many questions based on these results. Results. Okay. There are many questions. Let's see once more time. We have to show that the sum of four angles of a quadrilateral is 360. For that, first of all, you write in the second, we have to prove that theorem. First of all, we write the given. First of all, you write a quadrilateral ABCD and draw its figure in this way. Okay, that is right in given, and we prove it, angle A plus angle B plus angle C and angle D is 360. This is proved that. Okay, and we have to do some construction in this figure. We join AC. Okay, now first of all, now you write proof. And in this way, we prove it. First of all, we take equation, we take triangle ABC, and in triangle ABC,
we applying the angle sum property of the triangle. Angle sum property of the triangle. According to this property, the sum of all angle of a triangle is 180. So that is, we get angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 equal to 180. Okay, so in this triangle we find angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 is equal to 180. Now in triangle ACD we also use the angle sum property of the triangle, that is angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5. Angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5 is equal to 180. Okay, that is, we formed two equation, angle 1 plus angle 4 plus angle 6 as 180, as well as angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 5 as 180. Now we adding equation 1 and equation 2, we get in this way. And by construction we have angle 1 plus angle 2 as angle A, and angle 3 and angle 4 as angle C. And you clear from figure, it is clear from figure, angle 5 is angle D and angle 6 as angle B. So we have angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is 360. So in this way we proved that result. Okay, it is clear. Now we take some questions based on this result. Suppose the angle of the quadrilaterals are respectively 100 degree, 98 degree, 92 degree. Okay. Find fourth angle. Find the fourth. Find the fourth angle. Okay. So let's solve it. Let angle A is equal to 100 degree, angle B is equal to 98 degree, angle C is equal to 92 degree, and we find that angle D is fine. Okay, angle D, find that. Recently I proved, we have to prove it, since you know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is what? 360. So here we put all the values of A, B and C. We get 100 plus 98 plus 92 plus angle D is equal to 360. We add 198 and 92. We get 290 plus angle D is equal to 360. So we have angle D as 360 minus 290, get 70 degree. So your third angle is, fourth angle is 70 degree. Okay, in this way you solve all the questions based on this theorem. Now take some other question. In a quadrilateral ABCD, okay, the angles ABC and D are in the ratio 1:2, 2:2, 3:4. That is, angle A is to angle B is to angle C is to angle D is given by 1:2, 2:3, 2:4. Okay, now you find the measure of each angle. Your question is, find angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. This is your question. Okay, in any quadrilateral ABC, the angles A, B, C, D are in the ratio 1:2, 2:3, 4. Okay.
and you find the value of each angle, that is angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. Now solve it. First of all, we let here the ratio is given, na? Since A is to B is to C is to D is equal to what is to 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4. Now let A is equal to 1x, 1 not be written, B is equal to 2x, angle C is equal to, that is each our angle, angle C is equal to 3x and angle D is equal to 4x, okay? And we know that each the sum of each angle of a quadrilateral is 360. So we put the values of angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D in this equation. We get x plus 2x plus 3x plus 4x is equal to 360. So we get 10x. 10x is equal to 360. So that is 10x is equal to 360, na? So the value of x is equal to 360 upon 10, that is we get 36. The value of x is 36. Thus the angles are, thus the angles are, angle A is equal to x, angle B is equal to 2x, angle C is equal to 3x and angle D is equal to 4x, na? So we put the value of x in each, so we get x angle A as 36 degree, 2B, that is 2 into 36, that is 72 degree, okay? Angle 3 into x, x means 36, we get 108 degree. And the value of angle D is 4x, we put 4 into x value is 36, that is 144 degree, 144 degrees. In this way, we find all the angles of this quadrilateral, okay? Let's see once more time. In your question is, in the given in a quadrilateral, the ratio of the angles of the quadrilaterals are A is to B is to C is to D is equal to 1 is to 2 is to 3 is to 4. This is your question. And find each angle of the quadrilateral. When the angles are in the ratio, then you let that in this way. A is equal to, the ratio of A is 1, the ratio of B is 2, C is 3 and D is 4. So in that type of questions, you assume that angle A is equal to x, here 1 not be written, B is equal to, here 2, the ratio of B is 2, so we let B is equal to 2x, okay? Here the ratio of C is 3, so we take angle C is equal to, this is angle C, angle C is equal to 3x, same as angle D is equal to 4x. Okay, and you know that the sum of all angles of the quadrilateral is 360. So write in this way, angle A plus angle B, angle C plus angle D is equal to 360. And putting all the values of angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D in this equation, we have x, angle A as x, no? Angle B as 2x, angle C as 3x and angle D is 4x is equal to 360. Now we solve it. 1x, 2x, 3x, 4x. When we add, we get 10x. So 10x is equal to 360. So the value of x is 36, na? The value of x is 36. Now the angles are angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. 36, x, 2x, 3x, and 4x. So we find all the angles of this quadrilateral. Now you solve all the question of your NCERT exercise. Thank you.